Have you guys ever had a question about the Canadian Premier League but just never had anybody around to answer them? Well, you guys are in luck because today is your day. It's the AFC Curtis second ever mailbag episode. And of course, if you're new to this channel, welcome. I'm Curtis and this is my channel, AFC Curtis. Your home for just about everything in Canadian Premier League news and notes and interviews, all right here in this one jam-packed channel. So definitely check it out. Make sure you hit that red subscribe button so you can get up to date news and information with my videos each and every week. Now, you might be asking yourself as you watch this video, what's a mailbag episode? Well, in this episode, I'm gonna be answering all the questions that you guys submitted me over social media, as well as all my past videos, dating back all the way, starting back to my first ever mailbag episode, which was back at late May there. And ever since then, I've been able to gather quite a few questions here through the month of June and even the first half of July here and put them all in this episode. I'm pretty sure I combed through everything there, so I'm pretty sure I got all the questions I'm gonna have ready here in this episode. So make sure if you've submitted a question to me, you stick around to see where it lands. So what is your opinion on having a CPL team in the Canadian territories? Would you like to see a team in the Yukon, Northwest Territories, and none of it? Well, to answer this question, absolutely 100%. Yes, I would love to have a Canadian Premier League team in just every part of Canada. I think it would be fantastic. I think every place needs to have a local club, professional club, so they can help develop the local talent and bring them into a professional environment. I would love to have a team in the Yukon and all the territories. The problem with all that though is I just don't know in terms of the resources and the financials, if it's sustainable, if they could build a stadium that's big enough to house a CPL team for the long term, not just the short term 6,200, but could they have a 10,000, could they have a 20,000 seat stadium and sell out? You know, that's gonna be a tough thing to tell in the short term and even the long term future of the territories type soccer. And I think if the league does expand and have a second and third division, I think it would be great to have the territories as a good third division or possibly even second division team. Who knows, maybe they'd end up making a run and get promoted all the way to the CPL, the top division there in Canadian soccer. That'd be great to see. But overall, to answer your question, yes, I would love to see teams in the territories. I think it'd be great to have professional soccer and professional sports of any kind up in the territories. CanPL attendance has been pretty low for a top division league in a pretty large country. The CPL had its first ever match the same day as a Toronto FC game, and Toronto FC got a much bigger crowd. What do you think of this? Well, I believe ultimately people are gonna go to what they know. A majority of people are gonna go and attend events that they're close to and that they know of. The Canadian Premier League, as great as it seems, like you hear about it all the time, ultimately public-wide, it's still largely unknown. It's still a new league, it's still untapped potential for a lot of casual soccer fans. What's not on tap potential, what is a known, is the MLS, is the Toronto FC. Toronto FC has been around now for over a decade, so of course they're gonna get a bigger crowd than the new Canadian Premier League, because the new Canadian Premier League is new. This is only the first year, and in terms of the attendance records being low, I know it looks low. I think it's low maybe in some areas, like for York 9, maybe PFC and Cavs in Edmonton, based on attendance figures and numbers I've seen. But I think overall, you got teams like, you know, Halifax that sells out every game. You got teams like Forge FC that draw a very large crowd, I think 5,000-6,000 on average as of a couple, like early July. You got Valor FC, and I've been to those games. They're drawing 4,000-6,000 every game. I think that's fantastic for the league, and I think right now they should have this as their base marker. They should want to grow after this season, this year's attendance. And right now, you know, you got York 9, let's say it's hitting 2,500 seats this year. Let's try and grow that to 3,500 seats sold for next season on average. So I think overall this is a good first year to kind of just let everything settle and see where the average base attendance is and then try and grow it moving forward. With the Saskatchewan team rumored, do you feel the province should go with a province-wide brand team like the Rough Riders, or instead leave it open for a team in Regina and another in Saskatoon? Well, I ultimately think that they should just leave it not brand-wide for the whole province. I think they should just strictly do it like they've done it already, because I do ultimately see in the next 10 years for sure, we'll have a team in Regina and we'll have a team in Saskatoon. So I think it's best that they just leave it to just the regional area and just brand it like that, kind of like how we already have it with the CPL teams already named. You got Pacific FC branded kind of for the Pacific location, if you will. And you got Valor FC with their own local history making that team name. And you got Forge FC and the Wanderers all the same way, and every other club. So I think that's what they got to do, and they got to continue doing it even for these clubs here because like I said, there's going to be more than just the one club in this province. So would you like to see the Toronto FC, Montreal Impact, and Vancouver Whitecaps leave the MLS and come to the Canadian Premier League because they're Canadian teams playing in the American League? We'll answer this one. Yes, I would love to see every professional top-tier Canadian team come over to play in the Canadian Premier League. That includes the Ottawa Fury too. I'll lump them in there as well with those other three MLS teams. It'd be great to see. Will they make the jump? It's going to be hard to tell if they will, just because of all the money right now I'm sure they're making in the MLS. Overall, in terms of revenue and in terms of the business smarts of it all and the financials, again, they're most definitely going to be making more money in the MLS league than they would be in the Canadian Premier League. That, and there's more brand exposure and global exposure playing in the MLS right now than the CPL. I'm not going to close the door on anything because, you know, never say never, really, to be honest with you, in anything professional sports or anything really in life. And with that, I don't think overall though that Toronto FC, Montreal Impact, and Vancouver Whitecaps will jump ship from MLS to the CPL, at least not anytime soon, that's for sure. But I mean, overall, I would love to see them and Ottawa Fury come over the Canadian Premier League as soon as possible. I think it would be great for the league and help raise the level of the CPL. When the Canadian Premier League gets the second division, what will happen to the L10 and the PLSQ? Well, for those two leagues there, they're kind of like semi-pro leagues right now. And they're kind of, if you look at the soccer pyramid in Canada, they're kind of the third division as it is. Ultimately, I don't think that they're going to fold if, you know, the Canadian Premier League does get a second division. I think those leagues will stay. I think they're going to be staying for the future. I do. I think they're great development leagues for young talent and a good place to have as a third division for sure. So if they get a second division, I don't think they fold. If they get a third division, I ultimately don't think those leagues will fold either. I think they'll still be around. Why do Toronto FC, Montreal Impact, and Vancouver Whitecaps not play in the CPL? Well, for that one right there, I think ultimately it comes down to the MLS essentially owns the three teams. The owners essentially buy into the league. It's called a franchise league, and it's a lot similar to the NHL, the NFL, MLB, NBA. Where the owners essentially buy a spot or a placeholder in the league, and with that place they could put it wherever they want in whatever city they want. They can name it whatever they want, and that's what these three clubs essentially are. They're not single owned like they are in Europe or in the CPL, where every club is owned and operated themselves. They're kind of internal and they're kind of bouncing around all these leagues. The MLS is a lot like North American based leagues like the NHL and all them, where they are single owned. Plus, on top of all that, no shot at the CPL, but the CPL is newer, where the MLS is more established. It's got global awareness. The three clubs are getting more money for sure playing in the MLS than they would in the Canadian Premier League. And on top of all that too, like I said, the awareness and the brand awareness and the player potential is a lot bigger in the MLS, and getting those big players or to come to MLS versus the CPL. Overall, I think the owners would probably prefer, as well as the league would probably prefer, to all stay together in the MLS. What are the best and worst CPL mascots? So we got seven of them. I'm trying to think. The best and the worst ones, I think, are, I don't really have a best and a worst one. I like all of them for sure. I do. Some of them are a little scary, not gonna lie. Yorkie over at York 9, their mascot, pretty scary, pretty creepy. But he's like one of those scary types and charming types that, like, he looks scary, but when he captures you and stuff and you kind of look into those big scary eyes and he leans on like that soccer goal post, like in that one image, maybe you fall in love with him a little bit. I don't know. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section. But I think overall, Yorkie's the scariest one for sure. I do like Rover, because who doesn't love a superhero dog? And of course, there's Vic, the lion, who of course is fantastic. Winnipeg born and raised, got to represent. And I think the Rally Rabbit, I really like the Rally Rabbit. Really like Rally Rabbit for sure. Great mascot. You got the Cavs mascot, who looks like a horse that's on fire but also angry at you, really angry. And then of course you got, Stewie the Starfish. I love Stewie the Starfish. There you go. Stewie the Starfish, I love him. You also got the Dragon Sparks. Or Sparky, no, I think it's Sparks. Also kind of not creepy, a little scary. I think the scariest ones are Yorkie, Sparks, and then the mascot for Calgary FC also looks a little mad all the time. Maybe he needs to not be red, I don't know. But overall, I love Stewie the Starfish, because who doesn't love starfishes? He looks like a mixture of the purple guy Grimace and Patrick from SpongeBob. If they combined, if they fused, it's Stewie. So there you have it, right there. Those are my picks. Should one or two of the three MLS teams get a spot with a CPL team in the CONCACAF League? It is unfair for MLS teams to have one spot to go to the Champions League, while the CPL has two chances to go to the Canadian or the CONCACAF Champions League. So now to answer that question, I think overall, I do see it where it does look like it's a bit unfair, but I think overall, I think a lot of people, at least at the start of this season, just expected the MLS team to win the Canadian Championship every year and to go to the CONCACAF Champions League. I think though overall though, with how, you know, a lot of the teams have played, especially, you know, Cavalry FC this year has looked really good in the Canadian Championship, getting all the way to the semifinals as of this video. I think it would be a good idea. Maybe just leave it the way it is, to be honest with you. I think the Canadian Premier League should have a spot. As the champion of the CPL should automatically go to the CONCACAF Champions League. I mean, I'm sure it'll get that as time goes on and as we see the CPL play in the CONCACAF League and see how well they can perform there. But I think overall, I think the system's fine right now, just because I do expect MLS teams to still be winning the Canadian Championship over the next 3 to 5 years at least. I mean, there might be the odd time where you have a really good CPL side, like possibly Cavs this year, make that incredible run to the finals and even win the thing and go to the CONCACAF Champions League, which would be a fantastic story in itself to tell. But I think overall, I think the system right now is fine. I do see, though, where you do think it could be unfair, just because there could be two CPL teams and no MLS teams making it. But I mean, that's kind of the way it is right now. And I think right now it's kind of all right, because it is a little bit fair, because you kind of expect, the reason why it's set up this way is because everyone expects a Canadian MLS team to win the Canadian Championship, and a CPL team should automatically get a berth somewhere, and so they're putting them in the CONCACAF League. That's kind of the way it's set up right now. Time will tell if they change it or not, though. When will the CPL Championship trophy be unveiled, along with the split season trophies? Well, I don't think we're gonna get trophies for the split season. I think that's just kind of be like, oh, congratulations, you won the spring season or the fall season. I don't think we're gonna get trophies for those. As for the CPL Championship trophy, just based on what they've done already in the past and what their history is kind of like, I think they're probably going to unveil it like the week of the championship game. That's when they'll unveil it, or maybe even, you know, 2 weeks or 3 weeks out from the tournament as you start to get closer to the championship finals and the two legs there. I think that's when they unveil it. I don't think it's anytime soon. It's going to be closer to late October that they unveil that. Do you think the CPL teams should join the MLS and Liga MX teams for the League's Cups? I think that they should. I think it would be a good little test to see, you know, the best of the CPL versus the best of Liga MX and MLS. I think it'd be fun. I think over time they'll continue to do better. I think at the start they probably won't, but I think overall it'd be a great brand awareness for the Canadian Premier League. So my answer in terms of growing the brand is yes. When do you think the CPL will make a move for a Toronto team? Well, I think ultimately, what they should be doing, I don't think they should go after and go out and get a Toronto team to come to the Canadian Premier League. Unless it's Toronto FC, I wouldn't do it. They already got a team in York region there, just outside Toronto there, in the northern part of Toronto, who already is kind of, you know, maybe struggling in terms of awareness in year one, in terms of getting, you know, people in the gates and coming to their stadiums, only because it's hard. It's a hard market to kind of crack open, because look at Toronto. I mean, it's a big city. I know they got a huge population, so you imagine looking at the numbers on paper, they could potentially pull off of, you know, 3,000 to 6,000 seat stadium getting full almost all the time. But ultimately it's kind of hard, because there's so much noise from all these other leagues and all these other teams. You know, New York 9 alone right now is not even in Toronto. They're a little bit outside Toronto. They have their own big population as it is, but they're already having a tough time at having to battle the noise against Toronto FC, the Toronto Marlies, who's not even a Division 1 hockey team, and the Toronto Maple Leafs, who are one of the original six in the NHL, and the Toronto Raptors, the reigning NBA champions, and as well as, you know, the Toronto Argonauts, you even throw them in there. I mean, and the Toronto Blue Jays, you know, all these teams are already in Toronto. There's so much news, and there's only so much people will filter in and filter out. And in terms of this, if there's this new Toronto soccer team coming in, I don't think it would garner a whole lot of interest, to be honest with you, because they already have Toronto FC, and they already view Toronto FC as the team, the soccer team professionally in Toronto. So I think Toronto is a market we shouldn't go into right now for the CPL. I think the best situation right now is to just stay with York and try and build York up through the years, and they'll get bigger and they'll get better and they'll get stronger and wealthier. It's just gonna take a lot of time though. Other than a heavily rumored Quebec, Laval, and Saskatchewan team, team, where do you want to see future expansion CPL teams? Well, I did do a video about this about 2 weeks back, so I'll definitely have that down in the description below so you can check out there my top five places I want to see in the CPL in 2020. But to give you like a short answer, other than those three places, I think Ottawa would be a great place to go to, and then somewhere in, you know, Burnaby, BC area, or just anywhere kind of around the Vancouver area on the mainland of British Columbia. Those are the next two spots beside those three cities we just mentioned in the question. I think those would be my five places I would love to see a future CPL team. Which team has the best slash most hype supporter groups? I think for me, and I've only in person witnessed pretty much three of them. I was there at the inaugural game, so I did witness Generation 9, as well as it is the Barton Street Battalion there for Forge FC. And then of course, I'm always at the Valor games here in Winnipeg, so I know Red River Rising pretty well. They're always great and pretty loud. So I think out of those three, I don't want to sound biased or anything, but I mean, for sure, Red River Rising has been loud. But to be honest with you, all three of those groups, have been super hype and super great. And even in the loudest environments, I've been able to hear them pretty well. So I think all three of them are doing great. I think on camera there, I think the Lakeside Boys have been pretty good and hype. I think the supporters group over the Foot Soldiers, over for Cavalry, have been great. And of course, you know, you got the Privateers 1882, which I hear all over social media as the craziest and most hype supporters group. So maybe it's 1882. It's kind of hard for me to tell though, because A, I don't want to sound biased, and B, I haven't really been in person to witness all seven groups. So for right now, the jury's still out for my opinion, but if you have, you know, your pick as the most hyped supporters group, definitely let me know down in the comment section below. What is your opinion on possibly having a pro women's soccer division in the Canadian Premier League, and do you think it is viable in Canada? Ultimately, I think right now it's obviously a hot button topic kind of thing, because it is on the rise, 100%. I'm not disagreeing on anything. I think the women's game and the beautiful game is definitely red hot right now. It's on the rise. The last two or three Women's World Cups has just been gaining more and more popularity for the sport, for women and all that stuff. And the World Cup, FIFA Women's World Cup, is definitely very entertaining. Like, it's been every World Cup has gotten better and better. Entertainment value is better. I believe that their attendance numbers have been gaining more and more every time as well. I think there's more teams now that are able to compete for that World Cup than they were, you know, 10, 20 years ago when they first kind of started the FIFA Women's World Cup. So I think this is a great time for the women's game. I think it is growing. And I think in terms of having a pro women's division in Canada and with the Canadian Premier League, I think, sure, fantastic. I would love to have one. I don't know if they'll start one anytime soon though. I think originally when I heard in 2017 when they're starting the Canadian Premier League, I heard that there was also rumors that they wanted to branch off and have a Canadian Women's Premier League, which I'm totally for. I'm definitely for it. I want to see it. I think that overall, I think it's going to be viable. Yes, I think it will be. I think, will it have its struggles? Yeah, I think it for sure will. Every professional league, everything business related has its struggles. And I think the women's game is still very new, very fresh. I think it is on the rise. And I think if you can capitalize on that in the right way, I think that it will be viable in Canada, 100%. I think it will be. I think the US has a women's league right now, and I'm not sure the numbers on that. I would have to check that. But I think the women's league, in terms of numbers and finances, could be very well competitive with the game in the US and their US-based league. So overall, yes, I think it's viable, and I'd love to see a Canadian Women's Premier League. Well, guys, let me know what you guys think about all those questions. If you want to answer them yourselves as well, definitely let me know your answers down in the comment section below. And of course, if you like this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up, that like button to tell me you like videos just like this. And if you want to see more content just like this, make sure you hit that red subscribe button and a little bell notification so you can get notified each and every week when I drop a brand new episode just like this one. And you can also find my content over at northernstarting11.com. I'll have a link for that website down in the description below. You're gonna want to click that now. There's a bunch of great soccer related podcasts, vidcasts over there, articles all by talented Canadian journalists right down there. So definitely check them out. They work super hard on their crafts, and it shows, and they got some great stuff over that website, northernstarting11.com. Go click it now. And until next time, guys, thank you for watching.